Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. Hi, I'm Claire, and I'm a Senior Solution Architect here at Amazon Web Services. In this episode, I'm going to talk to you about how you can utilize AWS Conformance Pack and AWS Config in order to ensure that your database is optimized and resilient for your production workloads. So before we dive deep into the architecture, why don't we take a look about how we can have resiliency defined at the data tier level? We found customers always want to ensure their data is highly available. They can accommodate this by establishing various disaster recovery procedures, mechanisms for instance protection, managing version control, as well as monitoring analytics. This is applicable to whether you have a relational or NoSQL database for your workloads. Let's continue by understanding what AWS Config and Conformance Packs are and how they can actually help you. When you migrate your database into the cloud, there are so many services and resources that's available to you to ensure that your database is secure and highly available. One service that can help achieve this is by utilizing AWS Config and Conformance Packs. AWS Config is a service that lets you assess and audit your AWS infrastructure by monitoring and recording your resource configurations. This service lets you create managed rules, which are predefined customizable rules that AWS Config uses to evaluate whether your AWS resources comply with common best practices. You can also create your own custom rules. Any findings will result in either a compliant or non-compliant result. Another great feature of AWS Config are the Conformance Packs. This gives you the ability to bundle numerous rules together as a pack. This can be actually deployed as a single entity. The cool thing with these are that these are defined as a YAML templates. They're a group of config rules that are immutable, and users cannot make changes to the rules unless there's an update to the Conformance Pack. With Conformance Packs, you can incorporate both managed config rules and custom config rules. It is also best practice to incorporate remediation actions for any of those rules that end up being non-compliant. Let's take a look at an end-to-end architecture that is leveraging both AWS Config and Conformance Packs. We can see the end user has configured the AWS Config rules, and in addition, they are adding specific Conformance Pack rules from the YAML file, which are applicable to the Amazon Aurora database workload. We'll deep dive into a few selections for optimizing your database. From an architectural best practice perspective, it is recommended to enable RDS multi-AZ support. Configuring this parameter, it will allow high availability for your workloads. If your primary database goes down or if there's any maintenance that occurs, your workloads will not be impacted and you can continue your business as usual. Another great architectural pattern is ensuring you have enabled RDS storage encrypted and RDS snapshot encrypted. The following parameters will ensure you are complying with any compliance regulations. You are encrypting your data at rest, so no one will be able to access your data. So whether this is actually your data or your database backups, these parameters will ensure that your data is encrypted. To continue on the lines of best practices, we will want to ensure RDS enhanced monitoring is enabled. You can set up notifications if high thresholds are reached, such as CPU utilization. It will also allow you to dive deeper into understanding what processes or threads are utilizing that CPU. You will also be able to identify any I/O contention and total memory being utilized by any processes. Now that you have identified what rules are non-compliant, you have options on remediations. You could actually have Lambda functions call various API calls or scripts to execute actions on your AWS resources. You could also leverage AWS Systems Manager Automation Document to apply remediations on non-compliant resources. From there, you can have email notifications sent to you or your teams, as well as any third-party workplace communication tools using webhooks such as Slack or Teams. As a result, you now have an AWS environment that is governed by well-architected best practices. Today, you learn best architectural practices on utilizing both AWS Config and Conformance Packs to ensure that your database is resilient and optimized for those production workloads, as well as various techniques on remediating those non-compliant resources. For more information, please check out the links below. Thanks for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.